So does the fun ever really stop? No, it doesn't. What am I talking about? All the fun that we're gonna have here today. Today's video is basically just gonna be about two things. They're both costume reveals. Two that I'm not super excited about. Like, I'm not stoked about. Well, maybe one I'm a little bit more stoked. The other one I just think is kind of neat. It's definitely better than what I thought it was going to be, although I'm a little surprised that it is what it is. The first reveal is actually of the Jason Todd Red Hood suit that will be in season 3 of the HBO Max Titan series. That's right. Titans season 1 and 2 will also be available over on HBO Max as of November 1st. So, go there, or be square, or something. Anywho, let's take a quick look together at the suit that was designed by Laura Jean Shannon for Curran Walters' Red Hood to appear in season 3 of Titans. Also, if I could just take a quick moment here to point out that this would also be the first time that any live-action Red Hood suit has ever been created for any kind of official DC live-action movie or TV show or anything. So this is kind of a milestone, and it's very exciting for those of us who are Jason Todd Red Hood fans. The first image was actually just concept art that was revealed to us from HBO Max, showing what the suit's intended look would be for the series, and it got a lot of us kind of pumped, a little bit excited in the nerd department. And why wouldn't, I mean, just look at it. It looks pretty accurate to the comic book, for starters. Not long after that, a real actual photograph of the suit, a promo pic of the whole suit, showed up online as well. And the suit is pretty darn accurate to the comic books, although you can see when you look close at it that there are more than just comic book influences that have gone into designing the suit. Now sure, he's got the brown leather jacket, which is definitely from the source material, and the helmet looks like it jumped straight out of the pages of Red Hood and the Outlaws. I really love the look of this. Now some people might say that the helmet looks like it might possibly be a little bit big, but let's face it, he's wearing a helmet. In the source material, they don't take into account the idea that he's wearing a helmet on his head, so it would make his head look larger and a bit more bulbous. The helmet is basically the size of his head in the comic books, so that's obviously not real. In reality, when you put a big metal Domus helmet on your head, it's gonna take up more space. It's gonna, you know, make your head look bigger. But the look of the helmet itself looks fantastic. It's got the white lenses. It's a nice shiny red color. They so far appear to have all the lines where they're supposed to be, although I might say that we haven't seen the back of the helmet. Will this be a full helmet, or will it be a face helmet with straps and then a back piece? I don't know. I'm gonna say, judging by how comic accurate this suit looks so far, that it's probably going to be an entire head helmet. And the suit in general really does have a very comic book feel to it, but there are other elements to the suit I might point out to you. For one, he's wearing a red hoodie. And the red hoodie that he's wearing really speaks to me of the game Arkham Knight, because that's what he's wearing, a red hoodie under his jacket. His body armor kind of looks like dirt bike armor, but not. And it looks okay. It looks like for a guy who is going to be very acrobatic. I mean, remember, this guy was the second, the new Robin. It looks like he will be able to move around in this thing fairly easy because it's all, you know, compartmentalized. I don't like it when they gussy up Batman's armor with that kind of stuff, but I feel like this thing kind of matches, very much matches, with the Red Hood. The shin guards on the front of his legs really could be from the game, they really could be from the comic book material. The shin guards and the knee pads and the pants, they're pretty much par for the course as far as Red Hood goes. And then another thing that is different about this suit that speaks to me of a different influence is the symbol on his chest looks more like that redesigned Red Hood look that happened during Rebirth, where they totally went away from him having the helmet and the brown leather jacket. With that whole look was completely different. They redesigned him, and the emblem on his chest looked different at that point too. And that's what this emblem looks like to me. So it's like they've drawn from a whole bunch of sources, a whole bunch of inspiration, to make one suit that would hopefully kind of make fans of the game and of the source material satisfied. Personally, I can't wait to see this suit in action on the show. The Titans is one of the DC shows that I never fell off of. I watched every single episode of. Some I haven't seen anything of yet. Just I'm too busy and I can't watch everything. But The Titans was one on my list that I managed to watch everything they put out. So season 3, I'm sure is going to be crack-a-lackin'. And I can't wait to see this suit in action as he's bouncing around and doing his ninja stuff and shooting rubber bullets in people. Or maybe this is Titans. Maybe this Red Hood will be a full-blown killer. And then the second suit reveal for the day is that of Javica Leslie's Batwoman suit for season 2 as she portrays Ryan Wilder's version of Batwoman, because we all know that the original Batwoman has exited the scene and we have a new person that will be taking up the mantle. Now, a lot of people, including myself, saw Javica in the older Batwoman suit, that is, the one that was originally worn in season 1, and it wasn't doing her any favors. Javica is a beautiful, voluptuous woman. And it's important that a superhero suit should be emphasizing her natural beauty. Just look at this. For one, the hair is completely different. It actually looks like more natural hair. I'm not sure if that's Javica's actual hair. I'm gonna say it's likely a wig as well, but I think it looks great. I think that it looks natural and flowy. You still got the red highlights down in the bottom, but remember, this is a new person in the suit, so they don't need the hair to be exactly the same. It actually, Javica is a beautiful woman of color, and so the hair looks like the hair of a beautiful woman of color that's coming out of the top of the cowl. I think it looks great, and the cowl actually fits her face better than the original one. The original one, it looked like it was kind of crunching her face up a little bit and smushing her cheeks, and it just didn't look right. And then the suit, the bodysuit in general, has been completely redesigned. At first glance, you might look at it and say, well, that looks like it's exactly the same, but it's not. It is actually 100% different. For one, the bodysuit itself is 100% different. The details, how they've sewn the suit together, where the fancy lines are that emphasize her natural, voluptuous beauty, it's completely different. The utility belt on this suit also is 100% different. I love the fact they've actually put a bat on this utility belt. She's got capsules, she's got pouches. It looks fantastic. And then her gauntlets, choosing to make them red as another red accent on the suit with the three scallops. Oh, yeah, that just, mwah. Ryan Wilder as Batwoman is a brand new page. She's never been Batwoman before, but as far as I understand it, Ryan Wilder will also be making a comic book appearance, so she will have a comic book and an on-screen presence, although I don't think that she's going to be Batwoman in the source material. Have I ever seen her act in anything before? No! I just feel like this new chapter could be something really, really great if they don't crap the bed and drop the ball and then slip in the crap. Anyway, super friends, that's all I have for today. I will see you in the next one. Have yourself a fantastic, super awesome DC day, and take care of yourself. Bye for now.